is it?
Man City, Real Madrid.
Ooh.
Kiala. Look, 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 Jesus is king.
No hay gol, la tua no nanie.
Oi,
oi, oi,
oi,
oi, oi, oi, ele a cuai cu pono cu na na
na na na na
na na na
na na na na
na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na
na
na na na na na na na na na na na na na
na na na na na na na. Thank you.
You gotta show me the flavor you got.
Red and blue. Red and green.
Show me.
Malamara Aina. I don't know, I got to say to that. Whenever someone tells me Malamara Aina, I say, how about you Malama my nuts?
Is it fascinating you? Would you be able to dolphin dive off that, like in Assassin's Creed?
Shit, into like a hay bale?
A hay bale, yeah. Kella, how big would the hay bale have to be? Like a good 4-foot hay bale? Oh, that small? Okay. This one like this, just casually.
I'm not a fan of this.
I don't even have the paper.
I like the song.
Where's the paper?
He's feeling it. Ryan, you want to climb with me?
Our teacher's gonna play paintball.
Can I shoot teachers? Can I shoot
teachers? I have another announcement. There's senior blowout. And these are basically the flyers. The kid is gonna be like Smash Maui. There's gonna be stuff like open kava bar and stuff like that. So when you leave, have a flyer.
Look at her face.
Where is it? Look at her face on the open kava bar. Look at her face. Look at her face on the open kava bar.
Everybody mobs you, and you come back with a fucking gun like this.
Get the fuck out of here! He's not regulated!
Where's your mental at right now?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we're going to the cliff.
He grabs Alex by the fucking, like, by the sweater.
Oh
and
yeah!
Takes him out, and like, takes him out of the door. Get, like, just starts yelling at him.
Hey! Okay, wait, I'm gonna make it darker.
Yeah, Noah.
Noah.
Oh, deep up there?
Yeah, it looks so fucking.
No, yeah, with the river.
Like a cave, dog.
Yeah,
that's Ella Dean's dad's house. Sure, we...
Oh, I can see the water. Valley. You can see the river.
Like, I think it comes.
Oh, shit, split. You can.
See the water?
Yeah.
Oh, I see it. I see the river. Yeah, see
oh. Skeleton of a tree.
That is beautiful.
Yeah, it seems like we could. Or lions or something.
Said lion. No, but dude. Down there. Hey, right there, really right there, if there were lions up there, it would be
like
nuts.
Some safari fucking territory,
like
nigga.
Like Sahara Desert.
Oh, Schultz.
Schultz.
You guys shouldn't be too close to the
tree. Yeah. Local kid filmed someone dying off a cliff.
Off a cliff.
Cliff. Shut up. Honestly? So you just pulled up to regulate us?
I don't think I would step that far to the head.
What's up with you and these gun jokes?
Should I try and
or references?
Influence like us having fun in school?
Perfect.
What?
Should I try to write about us having fun in school into the writing?
Who has fun in school?
I mean like we do. We make the best out
of
it.
Nah, I'm joking. Wow, that's scary. That's menacing.
Was that it? Was that it?
That's the song. That's the song.
That was horrible.
I'm going to go.
Ooh.
Yeah, wait for this. Get a pass. How the fuck is it?
Like one that I can't keep is like my mental. Let's go.
Okay, ready? You fell.
Fuck.
Yeah, we didn't do it.
Where is it?
Over there.
From here? Can I get it onto the roof?
You did it. Good job. I feel like Antarctica's in my mouth.
Heyo, he's back. I got my boy Nixon with me. We're about to go look for some chupacabras. Follow me. Oh, he found one!
What?
What just happened?
I'm stuck.
Help me, step bro.
Help me,
step
bro. I'm stuck, man. You gotta help me out, bro.
Them? No. Let me just get B-roll.
Yeah.
Right here. Got you.
Fire, bro.
You don't even know what song we're listening to. But you can, because you know, you're the. We were having a conversation with that kid, and I started staring at Kieran, and it got super quiet. And then he was just like, alright, she's.
May 4th? This place is officially a fucking death town. We've officially killed our spot to hang out. What's happening is they're doing more wrestling. I mean, more boxing. Yeah, they're starting a whole boxing thing down there.
They're down below us.
No, it was yesterday we came over here and we were like, oh, what fight? And they're just boxing, dude.
But down there now?
Yeah, they got a whole little thing going. We just call them primetime boxing now. Another fucking boxing sesh.
Oh, yeah. Roger. I'm waiting right here.
Go, one hand, bro. I know, that's another thing. What the fuck? This kid has one boxing glove on. Throwing guavas.
Yeah. Oh, he took off a glove.
Whoa. Oh, brother.
He's done. He's done.
Like, it's not good fights, but it's just funny as fuck.
No, dude, it's pure fucking comedy right there.
You get 3 seconds,
bro. You have 3 seconds.
The fuck is this clown?
Pasamonte is coming.
Where? Oh, fucking clown.
Zip that fucker, though. Zip that fucker.
So fine, we go.
It's still John. John, go in the chair.
What the fuck? Oh, fuck. This is exciting.
You get it.
Jill's the king of scrapping, bro. He's even got the Marvel shirt on? Dude, you would knock someone the
f- You know I'm serious when I said it, because I've had bad trips, and I know how the mushroom guy can treat you.
Go. I think it was this kid.
I don't know, he told me to.
How you doing?
I'm living again, man.
Yes, sir.
You know, a couple years ago I was over here and I had that computer I had strapped to my back and I was still like not like...
You had a computer strapped to your back?
Yeah, I had
What was the computer?
For my broken nerve in my back.
Oh, you broke a nerve?
But now I don't have to worry anymore. Like, this is like only the second year because I was out there in the water more, you know, I got my things going and
yeah.
I stayed out there for a while and it just kept healing. So I'm like 100% since 97 when I got the Marines.
97?
Yeah, dang. I was pretty much not in good shape till since 97. So I'm just saying the truth of it all. Like, so I'm doing like this year, I'm doing it like 100%. Shoots, they put me out. They put me under like Demerol. They put me under every week for like a couple years because my body was going to shock and they needed to calm my system.
Really?
So I was going to go crazy.
Like some cryogenic
sleep.
Yeah, I mean, cryogenic sleep.
They put me out after the day just to let my body reset because my body was attacking itself. So they had to just put me down. Like one time I came from a state football game and my head was swollen up 2 inches off my skull.
Oh, what?
My girlfriend, she was the cheerleader, captain, she said, come here. And in school after the state game, she said, look at my eyes. I'm like, what? I'm fine. She goes, no, look at my eyes. I'm like, what? She goes, you can you? Like, I was fading away. I was blacking out. Like, I didn't even know what I was doing. I didn't even know I was doing it. It had become normal by the time I was a senior to have concussions all the time. You know, my head was just like always swollen. She goes, I'm glad it's over now. And I was like, why? She goes, you black out on me all the time. You don't even know you do it. Because I used to get concussions from hits, you know.
That's like, crazy, dude.
Yeah, because I was the co-captain of the football team. You were asking me how I'm doing, then now I made it through another war. So I've been through a couple.
Yeah.
Not real, but you know what I'm saying. I've been through quite a few battles, but look at us. You know, we end up like, look where we are. We learn and grow and stuff, but the world is hard. But then I come back in, and it's like when I would go back into the barracks for like a ball, we would like just blow it off, so we get it off our shoulders, you know. I come in here and we blow it off sometimes too, like, ooh, back, homies, what's up? You know, taking care of our squad bay and all that stuff, that's how we do it, right?
Yeah.
When you're out there and you get your own place, you're gonna go out there and then it takes time to sort of keep coming back and iron things out better. But if you went back to my pad with me now, I've been living out there 15 years in Kakloa. My place is like so tight. Like I have people coming from the DOD, like Department of Defense. I take care of all these people, like maybe like 10 people from the state in a year. But I'm out there like walking around and making sure they're happy too. But my friends are always there making sure that my eyes are open so I can like look at them and stuff, you know. because I've always been in that sort of circle. I started off when I was your guys' age.
Yeah.
A life flight crew, transport for life flight crew. They were so nervous when they got back from the lightning storms. I lost three of the crew, three full helicopter platoons of the crew.
Like, wait, and this was where?
They crashed in the storm, back home.
Back home.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
But you know, stuff like that where you come back and you regroup, and people in the community are like, we do need them, so he's our friend. Let's you know, help him back and get going again, just like coming off the field and having a concussion. But same thing, I said, I've been through a couple of those. But you guys are gonna go through them too. It's not gonna be regrouping your family after you lose your whole squad, but it might be just making it through some sort of not being able to pay for your bill for your car, and then finally getting back so you get a check so you can get your insurance paid and just get back on the road.
Yeah.
You know, we all understand there's bigger hills or smaller hills, but when you guys ask me how I'm doing, I'm on level ground. I spent a lot of time in a wounded transition unit. I was a handicap, registered handicap, because I was in a wheelchair for all those years. I had the whole community around me helping me get back up, but then I come and get back because it sort of made me see things in a way that allows me to help you guys see things and avoid those hardships and just keep going without going through the problems. But when you guys ask me how I'm doing, I solved my problems with my friends, and then I'm just saying you guys, you'll do the same and keep on shining by avoiding all those pitfalls. You know, when you're young, you don't see. I always watch out for you, like just like my mentors who are strong people. We're watching out for me. I'm going to say, how am I doing? I feel good because I'm here with you guys, and you guys are doing so well and shining so good. And I talk to the other classes, and they're like, we're doing good. Ask the other class if they feel like they're doing good. And then I talk to you guys, and you're like, we're doing good. So then that's like full circle. Theirs, get yours. Like, you're asking me how I'm getting mine, because you're getting yours, that means I did my job. Right?
Yes.
You guys, you understand that, right?
Dude.
You guys, you know?
So you guys understand, like, I had a conversation with those men, those guys who were ex-Vietnam helicopter pilots who took over life flight. They had flown all those missions.
Yeah.
I didn't ever get a talk from them. I didn't get a talk from them. They were so on task in those storms to do those missions. They were all from that field. They were all ex-military helicopter pilots. You had to have a lot of time to fly through those storms with patients on them, right, with the doctors.
So you were in Vietnam?
No, but these men that I catered to, they stayed in my house. Yeah. They worked in our surgical center. I transported them and their families and made sure they were taken care of. I had a talk with my father, who's a surgeon. I said, one of my friends like you, me and you in high school, like we were high school, my friend said, just like your mentality thinking, can Rick talk about stuff like that? Like, to people, like, is that okay? You know, we were just talking about in the office, like, and you're talking to all of them, and they're with us, like, the guys. When, you know, later on when you're older, if some people want to know, like, how you relate, it was because, you know, the things that you, like, helped calm the situations, and it made you that sort of person who, when the shit hits the fan, you are keeping your... yourself sort of
grounded. Grounded.
Okay, well, I'm just saying, I'm not a saint.
Oh yeah, I'm not a saint either. Yeah,
I'm not a saint, but I'm not perfect in my words. But I'm just saying, I talked to them and asked them, and my friends were there, like, you guys, well, can we talk about it? Can we talk about it? Is it bad about what happened? You know, to those guys who did crash and all that. No, they weren't bad people. They were just caught in a storm. But when later on, like, someone's asking how you're doing, I have nightmares about stuff sometimes. But I'm happy being around you guys and like just like them, like what's up?
Yeah.
Like surf a little bit, like. You know, there's many more stories, but I just gave you guys a few off the shelf, but sometimes I still have nightmares.
Yes, sir. Hey, you may think you're not a saint, Mr. Rick, but you're a saint, dog.
Well, you guys are part of my crew.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Hey, Trevor. That's Kelly, you wear that shirt every day. Does White Castle really smack that much? I've never even had it. You've never had White Castle?
I'm not gonna eat that safely.
Poser! Poser!
I'm not gonna eat that.
Mama!
I bust it down. Sexual style.
Tequila!